Waiting for the cheetah to wake up, Emily realizes something's wrong. The cheetah has stopped breathing, and his heart stopped too.
He's just holding his breath, start pumping his legs. He's holding his breath.
We start off by pumping his legs to try to stimulate him to take his own breath.
Just be ready, yeah?
Lift us up.
At the same time, trying to get extra reversal drugs into him. Be ready for him to jump up.
Stop. Anything?
His heart rate was also dropping, so we ended up having to give him some compressions.
I need you to go and get the tube, please. Where is the tube?
Mahesh, get that in. Right, stop. Get a pulse. Be ready for him to get up if he does. Got a pulse? Keep going. He's going to get up in a fright, so...
His heart rate has regulated, but the cheetah is still not breathing for himself, so Emily continues to do it for him.
Come on. Be ready. I mean, I'm going to get bitten if I breathe again. He's biting my tube, so... But I want him to breathe for himself. He's got a good heartbeat, so he's with us, but he's just too lazy to breathe for himself, so I'm helping him at the moment. I really wasn't expecting any problems. We'd completely finished with the procedure. Under normal circumstances, I would have been in my car not watching him by then. I'm keeping the tube in as long as possible because it's helping with his breathing, but what I don't want is for him to bite the tube and run off with something stuck in his airway.
Go for that adrenaline.
Just be ready. Was that him or me?
I think it was your leg.
Okay, this isn't... Move, just move, move, move. Stop, stop, stop.
The cheetah is awake, but the tube is still in his mouth. If he bites down on it, it could get stuck in his airway.
All right, boy. Well done. Good job, people.